Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Now celebrating 17 years of broadcasting success, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again. Well, these days, everyone is looking to get out a little bit. And even though you may have felt a little restricted, our next guest is part of a great project from National Geographic that reminds us of the beauty literally in our neighborhood. We're excited to welcome back Jon Waterman to our program. He's not only an award-winning author and filmmaker, but an adventurer himself. He's taken us around the world in his books. And in the book, Atlas of the National Parks, he reminds us of the beauty that's right around us. We'll talk to Jon not only about this book, but also how there's renewed interest, of course, in parks, with a lot of people looking for ways to socially distance and still enjoy the world. Jon, thank you so much for the time. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Jon, this is a beautiful book, and it does not only give us, I think, the beauty of these parks, but the history of it as well. What has it been like for you to see the interest in the parks, but also the history that you've been able to share as well?
Well, I think the popularity of the parks has everything to do with the fact that they are national treasures and that they were built for everyone to enjoy, not only today, but for future generations. And they're treasures because we've set aside wildlife populations and scenic treasures within that we can go at any time and see and challenge ourselves with on long walks or boat rides or first simply to go picnic and enjoy however we may.
Jon, are you finding, especially, I mean, in the age of COVID, that more people are looking for places like the national parks to be able to get out to stretch their legs, but also to kind of see the world in a different way?
Yeah, that's a good question. Generally, the crowds have exceeded expectations because people want to get out and get away from things and go on a road trip. These parks are more popular than ever before with record numbers. For instance, in 2019, we had 12.5 million people visited Great Smoky National Parks. Those are figures that we've never seen before in that national park, and it's true in most of the other parks as well. People are enjoying them in greater numbers now, so that's a good thing. But the challenge, of course, is to figure out how to continue protecting these places with the record weight of crowds visiting them.
Great point. And what I love that you and National Geographic have been able to do in the Atlas of the National Parks is, as I said, to show us the beauty, but also the history. As I mentioned, as an adventurer yourself, was that kind of part of the dual excitement for you to not only be able to visit these places, but also to be able to find the history behind them?
Yes. I was able to do a deep dive into researching each of these parks and to identify not only those things that we appreciate, like, for instance, the super volcanoes underneath the Old Faithfuls of these national parks, but to share a little bit of the history along with the earth sciences or information about the animals themselves in the national parks and the conceptual impetuous and rationale for creating these places.
Jon, you know, we all have heard that field of dreams adage, if you build it, they will come, and you really show that in this book. One of the things that struck me when I was prepping for this is talking about Zion National Park. And on page 233, for our audience who have the book itself, it's a beautiful book. You mentioned this: as trails and more roads were built, even more visitors came. And I think that is what's so interesting, even going into saying in 2000 when they implemented the power shuttle, that within a dozen years the shuttle system became swamped as visitation doubled. You mentioned, of course, that the beauty, which is that we're able to visit these places, but also the other aspect, and that is to be able to make sure these places are protected. What do you want readers of this book to realize their part in that, and not only enjoying the beauty, but the responsibility that comes with it?
Well, the responsibility, stems from the idea that these parks belong to all of us. They're public lands, protected public lands. And we have to figure out how to honor the idea that we created them for future generations to enjoy. So Zion's a great example because it's one of the more visited national parks, and because it's one of the smaller parks that the crowds can have quite an impact. But I think that to visit a national park, one should do a little bit of research and find out not only those parks that have fewer people in them, but if you're going to a place like Zion, how you would go there and get away from the crowds and avoid the popular destinations to see the sleeper aspects, if you will, of the national park, where you would go and hike and see things that are every bit as spectacular as those things along the roadside that have crowds of people beneath them. And that's the wonder of the parks, is that they're so vast. There's so much backcountry and so many square miles without roadways that you can get into the parks and get away from the crowds and enjoy them for the very nature that we created them for.
Right. And again, that's why this book is so important. Again, everyone, Jon Waterman has been our guest. He's not only an award-winning author, filmmaker, and adventurer, but he's been able to help us now to see the world in a different way, including with the book Atlas of the National Parks by National Geographic. Make sure you guys get your book, even if you don't plan on visiting some of these places physically. The book will definitely allow you to be able to see the beauty all across this country. Jon, how can our audience stay connected with you?
How can the audience?
Stay connected with you.
My website is www.jonathanwaterman.com. You can Google me as well, but Google, of course, the book Atlas of the National Parks. Visit your local library, where in all probability you'll find the park and the book itself, and be able to take a virtual tour through the parks by traveling through its pages. But in the end, you have to put the book down, leave the coffee table behind, and get out into the national parks and explore.
Yeah, and that is something all of us can do these days. Jon, thank you so much for the time. I really appreciate it, and looking forward to having you back on the program again.
Thanks very much.
Hey, thank you, and we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying, as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live. Now let's go make today amazing. Take care.